Hey everyone, welcome to Essentialist Video Marketing with Catalina, where I share marketing tips for small businesses. If this is the first time on my channel, please don't forget to subscribe. I post videos like this every Wednesday. So today we have a very special guest. His name is Fred Diamond, and he is a co-founder of the Institute for Excellence in Sales. He's also a public speaker in sales and marketing with over 30 years of experience and a host of the award-winning Sales Game Changer podcast. It's a podcast that is targeted to sales professionals, but as a small business owner and solopreneur, you're probably doing most of your sales yourself. So I definitely recommend for you to follow his podcast. I'm going to be leaving the link below. He also has worked as a marketing consultant for companies like Microsoft and Oracle. So in short, we're super lucky to have you here, Fred. Thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you so much, Catalina. I'm thrilled to be here.
Yeah, awesome. So your podcast, The Sales Game Changer, has been recognized as the top 15 podcast by FeedSpot, and that is amazing. So can you please share with us your journey since you started the podcast and until now that is a success? How was the journey, and what do you think makes it successful?
Absolutely. So it's called The Sales Game Changers Podcast. We post every Tuesday and every Thursday. It's audio, and I interview sales leaders, sales VPs, and executives. I ask the same 15 questions on every show. It's about a 30-minute podcast. You can find it on the Apple Podcast Store. Basically, I started the podcast because my customers are sales VPs. Mm-hmm. So I needed to think of a way to meet more sales VPs. So I just started the podcast, did some research, took a course. I was a DJ at one part of my career, so
that's awesome.
So I was very comfortable behind the mic, which a lot of people seem to be uncomfortable with, and just started scheduling appointments. And I made sure that I did a show when I said I was going to every Tuesday and every Thursday, the same way you post your YouTube show every Wednesday.
Yeah.
And people liked what I was doing. We put a lot of care into the production, and just really focused on making my customers look good so that my listeners would have a great show and they would get some value from it. So we're up to episode number 204.
Amazing.
We've had about 250,000 downloads, and it's just been a great experience.
You know what I think is really nice that you mentioned is that you put, it's 14 questions. Same, because I know as a business owner, we tend to like want to do all these things with marketing strategies, and then we complicate things in our head. But so if you choose the right 14 questions and then ask them to your interviewers, and it seems to be worked for 200 episodes. Is that correct?
Yeah. So that's a great point about simplicity. So I ask the same 15 questions on every show, unless it's a special episode where I'm interviewing somebody who is an expert on video or sales prospecting. But typically if I'm interviewing a sales VP, 99% of the shows, I ask the same 15 questions. And I do that for three reasons. One is it helps my guests prepare. Mm-hmm. So they know exactly what I'm going to ask, and they could listen to previous shows. Secondly, my listeners understand where the show is going to go. So they know if they've listened once or twice before or 100 times before that, okay, I'm going to ask, how did you get into sales? Tell us about some of the lessons you learned. Tell us about a sales mentor. Tell us about your greatest sales success. So the listener knows how to listen to the show, which is very important for listening and for video, for the listener, to appreciate the listener. And the third thing that's even the most exciting thing is we're repurposing the content.
Okay.
So we're posting the show, and we get, a couple thousand listeners, and we transcribe every show. So we get, we get about 10 readers for every listener that we get. Which is great, but I'm also using the data for other forms. So we produce reports, and we've produced some eBooks, and we're going to be publishing our first feature-length book in Q1. So there's so many things that we can do with the data by asking the same 15 questions.
And that's actually very interesting that you mentioned that, because that's something that I teach as well on my show, and I mean, use for podcasts, but for video, is like take podcasts and video as the base for your marketing, and then use that and repurpose that, because I know people trying to navigate the marketing world, and I know you have a marketing background as well, which is amazing. They try to do everything as a simple, like a separate thing, but really start here with the same questions, and then here with this content, distribute it.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
And would you recommend that, I guess, as a good sales strategy for a business owner, like to have a podcast, a video? Is that something that you recommend for people to do?
So most of my career was in marketing. So I've done tons of marketing activities. I was with Apple Computer in marketing, and you know, you mentioned Microsoft and Oracle as a consultant. So it's a great marketing tool. So there's two benefits that the podcast has helped me as someone mm-hmm. who sells things as well. Number one, I interview my prospects.
Okay.
So 95% of the interviews that I've done are with sales VPs who are my prospects. Customers of mine are sales VPs. So I've done over 200 shows. 100 of the people I've interviewed, I didn't know before I reached out to them. So 20 of them have become customers. So it's a great strategy to meet your prospects and help them get a voice as well. And the second thing is, by continuing to do shows twice a week, you know, like any type of marketing, people see it. Mm-hmm. And our main distribution is LinkedIn. We make a lot of use of LinkedIn. So people see me post every Tuesday morning, every Thursday morning. I do a very similar post about that day's show. I do a quote from the show. I provide a link to the actual audio, a link to the word, to the transcription, other information as well. So there's so many things you could do just by having one show. And there's so many ways that you can build your brand, build your business. But if I wasn't interviewing my prospects, then it would just be an interesting marketing exercise, which may or may not help. It's definitely helped. But the fact that I'm interviewing my prospects for a podcast is the best part of it.
Yeah, and I think it's one thing that I want to highlight that you mentioned was giving your interviewers a voice. Because a lot of people are not afraid to start and what are they going to talk to me or why do you even bother? You know, it's like, no, the people who you're helping them as well express their word and also their message, and you're helping them as well, as long as you're helping them, of course. I think that's actually very interesting that you mentioned that, and also the repurpose of the marketing, the content is huge.
The people that I'm interviewing, so they have three big challenges. Again, these are sales VPs at business to business companies. So they really have three big challenges: hiring, retaining, and motivating top tier talent. They all have that problem. So I can promise them, if they come on my show, I will help them be seen as somebody you want to work for, as somebody you want to work with, and possibly somebody you want to buy from. Although it's mostly the first two. I can help you be seen as a great person that people would want to work for, because people who are really good in sales have challenges. So if your target is entrepreneurs and business owners, you know, I would promise them the ability to, you know, build trust, you know, provide an interesting way that their customers could get value from what they're selling. So the point is, you need to provide value for the people who are guests on your show.
Okay.
So I'm very honored to be on your show to speak about my podcast. So thank you. And you've done a great job setting me up for some great questions. I do the same thing for my podcast guests. How am I going to help them present themselves? But we give them a chance to talk about their product or service.
Yeah.
We give them a chance. And I, as the interviewer, I want them to look as good as possible so that the show is going to be good. They'll tell their friends. They'll introduce me to other sales VPs. There's so many good things about doing a good podcast or a good video show like you.
Yeah. And then, so for the viewers, like, for example, right now I'm recording this in Zoom. So Z-O-O-M, and they have the recordings, and you can actually keep it very simple. And this is actually great content. I think what we're talking about is going to benefit a lot of people, a lot of business owners. And I'll include the links on the description as well, because I think anybody can start. Of course, quality and sound is very important, but the most important is you get started on the journey. And then you get better, right? It's like anything, you practice and then you'll get better. But as long as you get started. So I know your target audience is mostly VPs and sales, but what would you be like the three sales strategies that you would recommend for small businesses? Like what can we do, for example, like things that we can do right now to help our business? Yeah,
absolutely. So I would say three things. One is, It's about sales. So you may be an entrepreneur, you may be a consultant, you may be something, but at the end of the day, you're in sales. If you don't sell your time, if you don't sell your consulting gigs, if you don't sell your marketing materials, your designs, whatever it might be, you're going to be out of business.
Yes.
So you need to be conscious of the fact that, I'll tell you a long story. When I started out as a marketing consultant, you know, I was pitching myself as all the marketing services I provide, and I didn't have any clients in the beginning. And one day it hit me that I am in sales. I'm selling Fred Diamond's marketing services. Mm-hmm. So I need people to buy chunks of that. And then, of course, I'm going to provide them great products. So you got to know that if you're not selling your services, you're unemployed. You know, if you work for yourself and you have no clients, you're unemployed.
Yes.
Second thing is, it's not hard. Mm. So sales comes down to courage. It comes down to mindset. And it comes down to conversations. You know, being able to talk to people, but even more important is to listen. Mm. You know, when you get a possibility, when you get someone who may need your services, let them do all the talking. On my podcast, mm-hmm. my guests do 95% of the talking. I do 5% of the talking. Same thing in a sales call. You know, the customer prospect, they don't want to really hear what you can do for them. They want to hear that you can listen to them so that you can help them solve their problems.
Interesting.
Mm-hmm. Yep. So be conscious of, be a better listener. Mm. And third, one of the ways that you could become a better listener is by preparing, is by doing some research ahead of time on what some of their challenges might be, creating a better list of questions, you know, coming to the meeting with some solutions, you know, by giving some thought. You know, there's so many key words we keep hearing time and time again. One of them is preparation. Mm. You know, the first time you meet with someone, you got to know what they do. You got to know their challenges. You got to know their market. And then you got to come to the table with some solutions that you can provide for them as compared to, hey, Catalina, I can do these things for you. And then you speak for 20 minutes. They're tuning out. They're thinking about picking up their kids. You know, they're thinking about, you know, the Super Bowl. They're thinking down here in America. They're thinking about, you know, all these things that may not be pertinent, but if you let them speak, if you let them tell you and you're prepared to answer their challenges, your sales processes can potentially explode.
Yeah, because I know a lot of people, and I know I fell under this myself. Sales are usually like, you think of telemarketers, right? And people like calling you and they're like, buy. And also, like, I mean, you seem like now even marketing is different. Like, is you cannot even just like dump commercials and ads to people because you can skip them. Like, you have control over that. So it's about listening. And then, like, I love that, the preparation and the questions and changing the mindset around sales. And it's not about selling, but it's listening too. I know I'm repeating what you're saying, but I thought it was like super interesting because a lot of business owners, when you're just starting or your practice is small, you're just like, oh my God, I'm desperate for sales. I need to start, you know, dumping things. So change the mindset. I like that. Thank you so much.
No, that's a great point. And, you know, the customer doesn't have to buy. Mm-hmm. You know, the customer is in charge, and you made a great point there. There's so much information on the internet and social networks that they don't need you to tell them all the things they can do. They probably know ahead of time. And there's this, you know, like you said, you made a really good point too. When you're first starting out, you're a small business, you know, any opportunity, you know, it's like gold. So there's an expression that we have called showing up and throwing up. You know, you get the meeting and like telemarketing, you think, okay, I got 30 seconds. You know, if you start off the question, and it's not like, and not asking obsequious questions like, so tell me about what keeps you up at night.
Yeah.
You know, you might want to ask things like, how's your industry changing? Mm-hmm. Or why did you start the company? Mm. Or, you know, tell us about a partnership of yours that is really good. Tell us what your customers are demanding. You know, tell me about, what are the challenges that your customers are now facing that you solve? And it's like, I service the healthcare industry and our challenges are blah, blah, blah. And take notes as well.
Okay.
Here's one final tip is always take notes, physical with a pen, not into your phone or anything.
Yes.
Physically take, you know, something like a notepad or a notebook or something like that and ask the question, can I take notes?
Okay.
Can I take notes? Because the customers are usually going to say, of course they're going to say yes.
Mm-hmm.
So that's like starting what we call the elevator or the ladder to yes. Don't say, do you mind if I take notes? Because they're going to say no.
Yeah.
Always ask, you know, excuse me, can I take notes? Oh, yes, sure, of course. So then, yeah, you know, you start taking notes.
Oh, that's super interesting. Well, thank you so much. This is so, so interesting. And I know a lot of our viewers are actually female entrepreneurs, and I know there's a forum coming up on March 13th. So would you like maybe tell us a little bit more about that and how we can get involved?
Sure. So Institute for Excellence in Sales, our mission is to help sales leaders hire or acquire, retain, motivate, and elevate top-tier talent. So about 3 years ago, we started a Women in Sales program. And we do a whole slew of things. We're based here in Northern Virginia, right outside of DC, although we do programs around the world. So we have two programs for women in sales. We have what's called our leadership forum. And anybody can go to ESBD.com, and you'll see the link to our women in sales program. We actually have a conference coming up. We haven't started marketing yet, but it's going to be on July 21st in the Washington, DC area. A full day slate of programs for women in sales. So we serve a number of communities, sales leaders, sales teams, women in sales, typically B2B and enterprise level sales. We have a bunch of business owners, a bunch of entrepreneurs as well. So you can find links again, i4esbd.com. And I want to say, I think you're doing a great job. I think you're really providing a great service here. You know, people are looking for ideas or looking for tips. You know, I like the questions that you're asking, because sales isn't about intimidation. We tell people, when people tell us, you know, well, I'm not really in sales. Well, we like to say, if you have a child, a spouse, or a parent, then you're in sales, right?
Yeah, I have a 3-year-old.
Oh,
and
okay.
She started a negotiation. It's been interesting with her.
Yes, very, very good. And it's real. It's real. You're in sales. And it's, you know, if you forget about, you know, some of the negative connotations of sales, of pushy, and we just address that with, you know, show up and throw up, we believe that sales is a noble profession because you're helping your customer achieve their goal.
Mm-hmm.
And you have to have the commitment and the passion behind what you're bringing to market, i.e. selling, that you know that what you're bringing is of value to your customer. And if you believe that, then sales process is about helping them. Mm. And just admit, you're selling things. I mean, if you're an entrepreneur or a business owner, if you're not selling your services, again, you're unemployed.
Yes.
You know, you're out of business. You need to be selling your services. And that means the stuff that we talked about before, asking questions, having conversations, helping them. You know, the sale may not happen the first time. It might take you 10 meetings,
mm-hmm.
right? You've probably experienced that.
Yes.
with somebody, you know, just the first time that you call isn't going to be ideal, but, you know, engage in the conversation and show that you're providing value.
And I know, like, for example, for business owners, like, because that can get demotivated a little bit. We don't have a VP sales encouraging us, you know, every day, like, you can do it, you know, because that's kind of like, but it's kind of about thinking, how are you going to change the world? How are you going to help the world? And this is kind of how we support and help the making a change. So just a reminder for all the viewers out there that are kind of in the hustle. And yeah, it's about you remembering why you're doing this, and you're helping not only the customer or the person, but you're changing the world one person at a time. So there you go. That's my little motivational speech for the day.
Very good. You know, if I could just like say one last thing. I mean,
yeah.
If you're an entrepreneur or small business owner, there's a lot of stress. There's a lot of pressure, especially when you start hiring people and you have deadlines and you need to pay taxes and all these things. So I have a personal expression that I do. It's called BMC. Okay. Mm-hmm. Whenever I find myself in a moment of stress, BMC, the B stands for breathe.
Okay.
Breathe. M, meditate for a minute. Take a minute. And just think, just sit down, turn off the radio, turn off the TV, turn off the music that you have playing, and C, call a friend. Breathe, meditate, call a friend. You can't do everything yourself. You can't talk to your employees or things. You need this speed dial list. I have 5 people on my speed dial that are entrepreneurs or other small business owners, you know, organizational leaders that will take my call almost 100% of the time, unless they're in the middle of something. And I do the same for them. You know, sometimes you just need to chat for a minute, and then in a minute, it's good. They get you back in focus. They care about you. They know your business. So breathe, meditate for a minute.
Call a friend. Oh, I love it. Thank you so much. That is super, super good. Yeah, because we tend to want to do everything ourselves and we forget that we're humans. I have a lot of friends like they're entrepreneurs and that's exactly what we do. But so thank you. That's actually super, super helpful.
Thank you.
Yeah. Well, anyway, so thank you so much for your time, Fred. And if you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. And I will see you next Wednesday. Oh, and I'm going to be leaving all Fred's links on the description. So don't forget to visit them. Have a wonderful day. Bye.